All right, I figured some of y'all might get a kick out of this. What I consider kind of normal wear and tear on my airplane, since I do push them so hard and I'm very hard on my equipment to put on the shows that I do. Flying the other day, blew the head off the number two cylinder here. And you can actually see in here that it's not just, you know, necessarily a crack. That right there, it's actually, best I can tell, it's completely blown off the top of the cylinder barrel, right in the middle of the head there. And so we've got to take everything off. We've got the intake tube off here, the airflow performance injection system's loose on it, spark plugs, P-leads, all of that is out. Of course, the exhaust is off on that cylinder. And we've got just about everything off. Valve covers are off, and I've just got a few more turns on the front lifter rod tube. And if this cylinder head is completely blown off, it should just fall off in my hands. And that only means we're about halfway done, because I still have to take the barrel off to change the entire cylinder. Unfortunately, you just can't change the actual deal here. So, yep. Actually, there it goes. Making a mess. So, there's kind of what a blown cylinder head looks like. It's just too much pressure in the cylinder, and it winds up blowing that off. I'll set this here down. And take this. You can kind of see how everything is done on this. So the next thing I'm gonna have to do is get in here, which these are always a pain, and pull all of these bolts. And you see that's actually the piston on top. If I move the prop a little bit, you can see the piston moves. So finish getting those bolts off there and pull the piston out. And then the next thing here, we got the new cylinder that'll go on from Tulsa Aircraft Engines. All right, got all the bolts off of the cylinder base. So let's try to wiggle this out. Pistons all the way up in top dead center. This one's gonna be a little bit of pain, because every cylinder has its own complication. And this one is the main spark plug harness. Runs right next to it, really close. Okay, that's loose. Try pull this just enough. Well, we'll do that. Let me set the piston down. All right, so here's the barrel. Now pull the pin out. Put this piston in the new cylinder. It goes in like so. And take this. There's the crankshaft. Rods going to the other cylinders. So anyways, there's that. And we're going to load this piston in the other cylinder, and then we'll try to put the other cylinder on. Okay, we've got the piston halfway loaded. Got one last ring once we get up there, which is going to be a pain. So, depending on how long this takes, I don't know if I want to video the whole thing, but we're going to start trying to do this here. Alright, we've got the O-ring gaskets on there. This is centered, it's where it's supposed to be. Thank you.
And as always, Dracula is taking blood. That's seated in place. That pin's gotta be centered there, so we'll go a little bit farther. Last thing gotta do is try to get the final scraper ring in place. So, see if I can do this without cutting my hand anymore. Always a pain, and it's always sharp. Goes. Got the last ring in. So now lift this up, trying to get it to slide down and clear the harness. Put a little bit of oil on the barrel or the barrel of the cylinder, try to get this to slide in a little better. Also, thing I'm about to forget is you gotta slide these tubes, lifter tubes, into the rocker arms. Trying to do multiple things here. There's that one. Those are at least started. There's that. Make sure that these get in position. Lined up those. I just feel like those are in place. That's all the way down in position. All right. I'd already replaced the gaskets on these, so that's good. So now it's just a matter of putting the rest of it together, and I'll have the last part of that here shortly. All right, cylinder's all changed out. Base is bolted down, spark plugs, P-leads are all back on. Fuel injection lines are back in. It's all tight. Gonna come back and safety wire one deal there. Everything else is all locked in. Next thing is get it out and run it.
Throttle's cracked. Let me check. Brakes set. Switch is on. Master on. Boost pump. Clear prop. Thank you.
it's been about a day since we ran the engine, let it cool down overnight, everything. We did a compression check on the cylinder. It is 80 over 80, so cylinder's good. Put the speed ring back on, just finished pulling it through. Still gonna leave this panel off. I'm gonna check a few more things while I run, but I'm gonna run it up one more time, make sure everything's good to go, and assuming everything works out good there, we're done with the cylinder. So hope you guys enjoyed the video.